Praise the Lord, mighty prophet of the Lord.
Amen, Joanne. The Lord spoke with me about the meeting that is coming up to the French Guiana. Yesterday, the Lord spoke about this earthquake and the tremor with the tall tower, the metal plus the chain, the wire that is chained and woven like an electric cable. And the trembling and the running away and the sexual sin in that part of the world. And today the Lord spoke about the healing service, which is part of the second conversation on the healing service yesterday. When I said I see myself, it will be night time, and people are healed, and then the Holy Spirit comes from heaven as a white glorious dove. Today I can say it now. Comes as a white glorious dove over his servant during the healing service. And it's always my prayer that other people are able to see also, but sometimes it is the preserve of the Lord based on his wisdom, his hidden wisdom and counsel on what to allow people to see or not. So sometimes it is veiled, sometimes it's opened. I see the Holy Spirit coming from heaven at the healing service as a white glorious dove over his servant during the healing service. And it's at night because I see the light, the floodlight. And today he showed me this baby who is standing in front of me and the eyes are wide open. I think the Lord is also going to heal the eyes, open the eyes of a blind baby. I don't know if this baby stands up also, whether it's crippled also, but open in her eyes. It's a girl. The baby girl at the altar is healed. I see the eyes wide open and looking at me. Even now I see that baby. And that means the Lord is going to heal many people, open blind eyes there. And he's going to visit the nation of the French Guiana very mightily. I think this is the hour for the nations in that area in the Caribbean, that they can partake of the revival of righteousness and the revival of holiness. And remember, in this mission of the Lord, while he brings this tremendous visitation, this mighty healing to his people, still most important is going to be the restoration of the church and the call to repentance, the calling of the nation to repentance and the return to holiness and eternity, to prepare them for eternity. The biggest gift they are going to get in this mission is that they may also be partakers of eternity, may hear from the throne of God and what the Lord is saying right now about the coming of the Messiah. But there will be a huge visitation there, massive healing service. And the second part of the dream, I see people, there will be a lot of people, and I see the fences. I think they're using metal bars to restrain people in the crusade. And I see someone lifted up, it's a wheelchair, I think it's a wheelchair lifted up, and people are walking. There is a surge, because last time there was a healing service in Cayenne, it was so big, there was a situation there where people were being healed, so and so has walked, this woman has walked, it was a big situation there. I see a similar situation where people are surging, they are coming, and they are carrying, I think it's a wheelchair, I see the two arms of the wheelchair, I see them lifted up, and what this kind of situation I see there. And there is a surge, so there are metal bars that are used to restrain people. So there's going to be a huge revival breakout in this very blessed nation of the French Guiana. The Lord appears to be loving this nation so much, to say that this is going to be an epicenter of revival in that part of the world. So this is what I see now. I see the metal bars that are normally used by the police to restrain people. People are being restrained. I see wheelchair carried up. I see the two arms, two metals on the back of the wheelchair lifted up, and people are coming with it, and there's a situation there, and this tremendous visitation that will take place in Cayenne. Again, last time, the Lord brought me to Cayenne, and he did a healing service. There was a huge situation. People were walking that had not walked, people who could not walk stable, this woman, the blind that was seeing, many things, the deaf. Many, many things happened there. It looks like the Lord is going to do this higher, to another level of revival. And that's why we have been observing a lot of prayer and fasting all throughout. ever since I came back from the healing service in South Africa, a lot of prayer and fasting. And I'm also praying that the Lord can speak rain to them also in the French Guiana, like He spoke in Nigeria, South Africa, Kenya, that the Lord may rain, that it may rain in all the nations, that all the nations may behold this prophecy of the rain that changed the life of the church in Kenya forever and catapulted the church into heaven, that this rain may fall in all the nations, that they may all be partakers of open heaven. But this visitation, when the Holy Spirit comes in the glorious dove that I have seen coming down, that is also already open heaven for that land. And so this is the time when the Lord promised He would revive the church. He would bring the latter rain, the latter glory, the latter visitation, that every nation may be a partaker of the glorious kingdom of God. What an awesome time to be a Christian. What an awesome time to be alive, to see the reviving of the church and the preparing of the way for the glorious coming of the Messiah. So as I come to the French Guiana, I've seen a big healing service that will take place in that land. And it's going to be a mighty, mighty visitation to behold. And mine is to bless all the nations tuned in now, to pray that all of you may also be spoken about by the Lord, that the Lord may speak to me about you, because this is the train that is going and preparing the way for the coming of the Messiah. When it reaches every nation, He stops and He asks the people to come on board before the train leaves the station, and then to the next station, to the next station. And those stations are nations, 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 that at the end, when the Messiah comes, the nations may be gathered, the sheep nations, not the goat nations, the sheep nations may gather and may enter into the glorious kingdom of God. May the Lord bless every nation that is tuned in, that they may also claim their position in this revival. They may also be in prayer and groaning and crying unto the Lord, that the Lord may speak open heavens to them also, that the Lord may speak to His servant about their visitation also. I bless you all. The Messiah is coming. Let us all prepare in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.